A founding member of Fathers for Justice, a group which campaigns for a fatherless society. Now, Matt, you have a few reservations about the sort of quickie divorces as well, I think on similar grounds to what Joanne was just saying there.
Yeah, I mean, similar-ish. I mean, our issue, Alex, is that the no-fault divorce laws won't really change a huge amount apart from remove many men from their children, from their homes, and from their assets quicker than ever. All the outdated sexist notions of divorce remain. The assumption, this prehistoric assumption that children live with the mother, and therefore, you know, the mother and the children live in the same house, and all these ridiculous notions. And what no-fault divorce is, you know, is manifestly misrepresenting. It says it's going to remove the blame game. Like Sam has been wonderful panacea, you know, there's going to be, you know, rainbows over the Royal Courts of Justice, unicorns running down the Strand. It is a nonsense, because what will happen is the problem, particularly if you're married and you have children, the problem is simply displaced into the family court system, which is broken, which is secretive, which doesn't have enough judges at the moment. They're literally digging family court judges up out of the graveyard. The problems are simply displaced. And for us, this is the problem here, is we need genuine, meaningful reform. We need divorce equality for men and women. We need parental equality for dads. We need to change the notion that women, that mothers, are chained to the sink at home with their kids. Let's plug fathers back into families and get better outcomes for our children, our parents, and our country, most importantly.
Does it worry you that with the new sort of no-blame divorces, no-fault divorces, just one party can go and ask for a divorce and doesn't have to have a reason for doing that? Does it worry you that there could be situations in families where, rather than the couple almost being forced to work on their marriage, to really, you know, take steps, whether it be seeking counselling or, you know, whatever it may be, to try and hold the household together, it will become way too easy for just one parent to say, I'm done with this, I'm off, and it gets wrapped up pretty quickly?
Well, it makes a mockery of our idea of marriage, doesn't it? That you can, it's what I call marriage, the fraud of the rings. You know, you've got the engagement ring, the wedding ring, and the supper ring. And the point is, as soon as somebody thinks the grass is greener on the other side, right, they're going to leave that marriage, that commitment you make. Many people still make that commitment in church. It's meant to be a lifelong commitment, but we undermine it. The Church of England, who sells you marriage, you know, the institution of marriage, you know, they don't provide you with any, you know, off you go down the M1 in your little car, marriage car, wedding, just married, looks fantastic. But when you break down, when there's a relationship breakdown, there's no after-sales service. There's no roadside recovery. There's no support for you. And the idea that we can just walk away from marriage as a sort of transactional deal that you'd have had with some retailer, it just makes a mockery of it, Alex. And, you know, I take a view, having been married twice and being that stupid, you know, that I think men particularly, when they're looking at getting married and we're conditioned to think that marriage is this panacea, lifelong happiness. I mean, men in particular need to look at what that contract means and the onerous responsibilities and the punitive nature of that. If you're a man, they need to step back on that, because there is a deadly divorce trap. The deadly divorce trap is that if you get divorced as a man, you're three times more likely to take your own life. 70% of separated men live in poverty. You're going to end up in a bedsit. You're going to end up in a shared accommodation. The outcomes for men are pretty bad. And so I think we need to have a proper open debate about all the issues here and say, not this tinkering around with divorce. We need genuine, meaningful reform, divorce equality and parental equality. Why can't dads have the same rights as mothers? And as Gloria Steinem said, the American feminist, women can't be equal outside the home until men are equal inside the home.
Matt O'Connor from Fathers to Justice, it's been great talking to you on this subject. Now, quick.